PC again. So this is the second part of my video about temporarily fixing your MacBooks that has a black screen. The first part would be in my link description, so check it out first before you proceed here. Okay, so the second thing that we would do for the second part of the fix is to download a program called GFX Card Status. Okay, so it will be provided also in my download link in the description. So download it first, then install it. So for me, I already had installed the program. So you would see an icon here after you finish installing it. Okay, so the first thing is to go to preference. Okay, uncheck this one and uncheck also the check for update. Then check the low GFX card status. So you're checking this one so that it would auto start up when the Mac OS is finished loading up. Okay, so you would check here the integrated only option. As you can see, we are using the Intel HD graphics 4000 because the NVIDIA, the second chip, the second GPU, is busted or has a problem. That's why it's causing it to black out or having no display when you're starting up your Mac. Okay, so this script only is for the second GPU, and the dynamic switching is for auto switching between Intel HD and NVIDIA or AMD card that you have on your Mac. So we would choose this one, integrated only, so that it would not have any issue lagging, restarting, or whatsoever. So we could just back up the files. You could back up the important files that you have and whatsoever that you need to do with your Mac. Okay, so I'm running this. I'm using a MacBook Retina mid-2012. So as you can see, in our first video that you have done already, as you can see, the NVIDIA GPU here is not indicated because it's off. Because in the first video, it switched the GPU to the graphics card, to the HD graphics card. That's why it's working now. But whenever it switches up to the NVIDIA GPU, it would really cause problems. So before getting your MacBook in Apple centers, and of course they would find the diagnostic that it would cost you an really expensive box just to repair or replace that motherboard, you could check our Facebook page, stage3pc.com, or facebook.com/stage3pc, or in our YouTube channel, stage3pc. So I think that's it. Please subscribe and share, guys. So this is the second part of the temporary fix for your MacBook Pro. Remember to download the program, install, and choose integrated only. So if you restart or shut down this Mac and the problem persists again, you just do the first part of the video so you could get it working again. Okay, guys, thanks.